Eastern Midnight! Brought to you by Ovaltine. Chocolate-flavored Ovaltine. Delicious, nutritious, instant Ovaltine. The fortified food drink that tops them all. Now for a visit to the Secret Squadron Hall of Fame.
Well, here we are, Pat, Peggy. Every one of these great athletes is a member of the Secret Squadron.
Gee, Crazy Legs Hirsch.
Yes, one of football's all-time greats. And Duke Snyder, a real big leaguer and home run slugger for the Brooklyn Dodgers. Peggy, you should know who this is.
Florence Chadwick.
Yes. Florence holds the world's record for swimming the English Channel, the only woman ever to swim it both ways. Let's join her on the beach. Florence, how do you keep yourself in condition?
By getting plenty of sleep, exercise, and the right kind of food. And I drink chocolate-flavored Ovaltine. Remember, I said Ovaltine. An athlete wants real nourishment, not just the flavoring for milk or a drink with just a few vitamins.
Right, Florence. Athletes do need the right kind of nourishment, and Ovaltine gives you extra vitamins, minerals, and other important food elements.
And chocolate-flavored Ovaltine is delicious, too.
Right again, Florence. Boys and girls, drink your Ovaltine every day. Just as Florence Chadwick says, get chocolate-flavored Ovaltine.
On a mountaintop high above a large city stands the headquarters of a man devoted to the cause of freedom and justice. A war hero who has never stopped fighting against his country's enemies. A private citizen who is dedicating his life to the struggle against evil men everywhere. Captain Midnight.
Forward crawl control. Slow speed. Contact. Stand by for the shock voltage test. I'm going to charge that torpedo with 10,000 volts. Shock voltage control maximum. Now watch it knock out that enemy soldier. Breaking contact. Perfect. Congratulations, Professor. You've made what appears to be a potent addition to the weapons of democracy, the Hoffner Land Torpedo.
This will certainly establish your husband as a top scientist in the United States, Mrs. Hoffner.
You are too kind.
Thank you, my friends.
So when are you going to load it with TNT and really blow something up?
No, this is no toy, Icky. With a proper warhead, it could knock out a gun emplacement.
Or a whole battle position.
Properly employed, it'll do almost anything a soldier can do.
Anything a soldier can do?
Nah.
That thing will ever stand KP, clean garbage pails, and peel potatoes.
What's that?
That's the telescreen signal. We have a visitor. Icky, go see who it is, will you, please?
Roger.
Captain Midnight? Oh, I mean, I wish please to see Captain Midnight.
Oh, what about?
Because I have run away from my home. It's most important.
Okay, follow me.
Captain Midnight? Yeah?
Yes?
Many nights I have heard your voice over Radio Free Europe.
You're from Europe? But those broadcasts of mine are beamed to unfriendly countries. Here, sit down.
Thank you. I have escaped, Herr Captain, from my country. So I run away.
So I'm running. Then how'd you get all the way across the ocean and then here?
On a ship. I stood away on a ship, sir. I've been from the police hiding ever since. They send me back if they find me. I can't go back. I do not want to go back. Please.
Now, don't worry about it. I'll have a talk with the immigration department in the morning.
You mean I can stay in America?
Well, I can't speak for the government, but I can tell you this. America was founded by people who ran away from cruelty and oppression.
That's right, fella. By the way, what's your name?
Stephen Bork, sir.
We'll call him Steve, huh?
Right. What about your family?
My mother and father died in concentration camp.
I see.
Oh, I lost it. That first food you called, hot dog?
That's right, hot dog. Don't worry, I'll get you another one.
No, sir. It was my own fault. Please, I'll go myself.
Okay.
You know something? That thief's going to be a regular American kid.
He sure is.
Accepted my story.
Good.
I am now living at Secret Squadron headquarters.
Very cool. Have you seen the new weapon, the land torpedo?
Yeah. Captain Midnight has built it from Hoffner's design. But I am not allowed to go near it.
Oh, but we must find an opportunity. At night, perhaps, when they are all asleep. Get me photographs of it with this micro camera, huh?
Steve's been gone a long time.
Maybe he got lost.
I'll go take a look.
He took the
weapon.
I remember perfectly.
Bring the photographs to the woodcutter's shack. We will be waiting.
Fine.
Quick.
Oh, there you are, Stefan.
Yes, sir. I got lost.
Well, I was looking all over for you.
A run home, maybe?
You mean a home run. Let's go back to the game. Yes, General. The blueprints of the torpedo are complete. Well, I can fly to Washington with them tomorrow. All right, sir. Be in your office at 10. Good night, sir.
Here.
I don't know. Must have left that shock bolting partly on. Tuck, get in and kill that switch and turn some lights on in here.
Right.
You're all right now, Steve.
Stephen, what were you doing down here? What happened to you?
I don't know. I must have walked in my sleep.
Have you ever done that before?
Oh, yeah. Many times at home when I was dreaming of bombing.
Oh, poor boy. It is so with many children who were helpless victims of the war.
You can open your eyes now, Steve. You're safe.
You saved me.
Say, how would you like to sleep in my room for tonight?
In your room? I would be allowed?
Why, sure. What do you say we hit the sack?
Right.
Come on, Steve. Take it easy. You're going to be all right.
Thank you.
Come in.
Have you brought them? The photographs of the torpedo.
No, Herr Hunter. I did not obtain them.
No?
I could not. I lost the camera.
What? Lost the camera?
You little fool! Oh.
Why, this is too bad, Stefan. Sit down in that chair there. Sit down.
Oh, sit down.
He's lying. Let me handle this. It was a bad luck losing the camera, Stefan. But I have another one. You know where?
No, Herr Hunger.
In this watch. Now keep your eyes on my watch, Stefan. Relax. Keep your eyes on the watch. Do not try to think of anything. I will be guiding your thoughts. You're getting sleepy. Now tell me, why did you lose the camera?
Because Captain Midnight, he's so kind to me. He saved my life from the torpedo.
But you did photograph it, didn't you, Stefan?
Yes.
Then where are the films?
The camera. Here in my belt.
Oh, give them to me. Give them. That's good. Just relax.
Develop them quickly.
Extraordinary. My congratulations, Captain Midnight.
Well, thank you, sir. But the congratulations should go to Professor Hoffner. It was his brainchild.
Whoever's responsible, I know the combined chiefs will want to see these blueprints just as soon as possible. There's a staff meeting scheduled for tonight. I'd like to have you stay for it, in case they have any questions.
Well, I'd be very happy to. But in the meantime, I wonder if you would excuse us. We have some other important business.
As important as this land torpedo?
Well, I've got to see immigration about getting a permit.
Yes, so we can find a home here in America for a refugee boy. Don't forget we promised to get him a present. Then don't let me keep you. There's nothing more important than keeping a promise to a youngster.
Thank you, sir. Go, Icky.
Time out now to relive something that happened recently in headquarters.
You know, Tut, no matter how hot or tired I am when I come in from a mission, that Tut special you make with Ovaltine always brings back my rocket power. Show us exactly how you make it, will you?
Right. It's quite simple, but I do take pardonable pride in the mixing. I take a large jar of instant chocolate-flavored Ovaltine and put 3 heaping teaspoons in a big glass. Then, here's the big secret. I pour in just enough hot tap water to cover the Ovaltine. See how it dissolves and starts to look good and chocolatey? Then I fill up the glass with ice-cold milk. And look what happens now. It all starts to blend together. Then I stir it a couple of seconds till it gets nice and bubbly. And there you are, Captain Midnight. You've Tut special.
Boys and girls, get a jar of Ovaltine today and mix yourself a Tut special. You'll love it. So every day, drink instant Ovaltine.
Excellent. Our little Stefan did his job better than he knew. These films, our engineers back home will be able to reconstruct the torpedo in exact detail.
Good. Then we better pack up and leave before Captain Midnight misses Stefan and starts looking for him.
No, Harry. There is one detail of unfinished business.
Oh, no explosives.
Yeah. You sleeping, Stefan?
Yeah, Herr Randall.
Good. You will sleep more deeply still. And though I will not be with you, you will obey my order.
Yeah, Herr Randall.
You will return to Captain Midnight's headquarters. Tonight you will seek out the torpedo secretly. You will place the cylinder in the nose of the torpedo just behind the detonator. Do you understand?
Behind the detonator.
You are a good boy. Good boy, Stefan. Take this. Put it in your pocket. Good. You are a good soldier. Open the door. Now go. And obey. Obey.
Yeah, Stefan.
But when Stefan has armed that torpedo with our newer explosive, the first time it comes in contact with anything, it will blast Midnight's headquarters to ruins with everyone in it.
Precisely. And no one in the world will know how to construct the Hoffner torpedo but our engineers.
Approaching headquarters. Prepare for a landing.
I'll radio Tuck to turn on the runway light.
No, skip it. We'll use our remote control. No use waking up Steve and the whole household.
Bet you Steve wouldn't mind being waked up if he knew we were bringing him back for a present.
After all these years, high officers of the United States Army come here to talk to me to inspect my torpedo.
And before the general arrives with that plane load of top brass, we'd better run a final full-dress test.
Yeah, nothing must go wrong.
You work the controls, Professor. You
yeah.
And Tut. Right. Icky, you scare up that enemy soldier with a tin hat. I'll check the model.
Excuse me, Captain Midnight.
Yes, Miss Hoffman.
I'm worried about Stefan. He doesn't want his breakfast. I think he is ill.
Oh, well, I'll go right up. When he sees what Icky and I brought him from Washington, he'll perk up fast enough. Start the test without me. I'll be right back.
Yeah.
Since this will be our last test under controlled conditions, let's start with a longer run. We'll send the torpedo out to the study, around the desk in there and back.
Very good.
Oh, hold that aside, Icky. We're going to run a distance test first.
Okay, but tie down that shock bolted switch, will you?
Don't worry. It's not loaded. Ready, Sven?
Yeah.
Contact.
Steve, what's all this I hear about you not feeling well?
Nothing. It's nothing.
Well, remember the present Icky and I promised to bring you? This is it. The baseball. Autographed by all the New York Yankees. Look. He seems to be in some sort of a trance.
I know.
It's almost as if he were hypnotized. That's the first reaction I've been able to get out of him.
But what can we do? If he is hypnotized, how can we bring him out of it?
Well, it's almost impossible. But there have been instances. If the subject can be won over by a stronger personality than the original hypnotist. Look at me, Steve. Fasten your eyes on mine. I'm your friend, Steve. You're safe now in America. Safe from the bombings and prison camps. You're safe now. Put yourself in my hand. Nothing can hurt you now. Believe in me, Steve. Trust me. You do trust, don't you, Steve?
Yeah.
Right rudder, it's going to crash the desk. Half speed, right control. Attaboy, Cut. Nice backseat driving.
You feel safe now, don't you, Stefan? You trust me. I am your friend.
Your friend.
Now, I'm going to tell you to do something, Steve. Something very important. To me, Steve, and to you. Because we're friends. I want you to wake up when I clap my hands. Wake up!
What happened? Captain Midnight!
It's all right now, Steve. It was just a bad dream.
Bad dream? No, it's true. I put something in the torpedo.
You did, Steve? Where? When?
Last night. Where the grooves are prepared. Behind the detonator.
The warhead!
Stand by for shock voltage test. Back on the rubber mat. Shock voltage minimum. Forward control. Contact.
Cut, Mr. Harper! Stop the torpedo! Stop it! Stop it! Pull it! Quick!
What's the trouble? What's the matter?
Stand back! Yes, it is. I just learned from Steve that somebody's trying to blow us up so they can have the torpedo exclusively. Take over, Tut. Hickey and I will follow it up.
Right.
Come.
The torpedo. Look out.
Everyone has betrayed us.
You in the shack there. Come out with your hands up. This is your last chance. Come out with your hands up.
Not coming.
Well, they're not shooting either. That means they're unarmed. Hold the torpedo! Let's go in and take them.
Their car, they'll never catch us.
No, wait, I have a better idea.
Look!
This is the end, Captain Midnight. I'm going to blow you up with your own torpedo.
And the secret of the torpedo will be exclusively ours.
What about this control panel?
Get an axe from the woodpile. That will do the whole job.
Thank you. Pinky, take care of Tut. Get a rope and tie those guys up.
And that's how the Hoffner torpedo won its first scrap with the enemy.
But then, dear, still yeah. I do not understand. Captain Midnight removed the explosive here in the laboratory. How then could the torpedo blow up the shack?
The torpedo didn't, but the explosive did. I took it along with me in my pocket, just in case of an emergency. When we realized they thought they had us trapped, Icky and I hopped out a rear window, tossed the explosive back in.
And boom! No shack. It worked like a charm.
Right. They dropped their guard, thinking we were dead.
I'm glad you were not dead. I would have never forgotten myself.
Forget it, Steve.
Captain Midnight knows how terribly sorry you are, Stinson. And he has some good news for you. And for us.
Oh?
When I was in Washington, I arranged to get your immigration permit. And Mr. and Mrs. Hoffner have asked to adopt you, to take the place of their son, Paul.
Boys and girls, because we've had so many requests for secret squadron emblems, we've arranged for you to have an official emblem for your very own, just like this one that I wear. And I want every one of my friends to wear one. You can never tell when it will be important. For instance, in case I need your help, I can recognize you on the street. Now, here's how to get your Secret Squadron emblem free. Go to your food store and get delicious chocolate-flavored Ovaltine. Here it is. Attached right to the top of the chocolate-flavored Ovaltine jar is your free official Secret Squadron emblem. You can wear it on your shirt front, or you can change it. Put it on your sleeve, or your hat, or your bike. Better still, get several emblems so you'll never be without one. So today, get delicious chocolate-flavored Ovaltine. Remember, at the top of each jar, you'll find an official emblem. There's no extra cost, not one penny. Be the first in your neighborhood to wear your Secret Squadron emblem. But hurry, the supply is limited. When these emblems are gone, there'll be no more. So get your Secret Squadron emblems with chocolate-flavored Ovaltine today. Now, get your pencil and paper ready for our three-word secret clue to next week's exciting adventure. Write down these numbers. First word, 3, 8, 18, 7. Second word, 11, 16, 20, 11. Third word, 24, 8, 22, 22, 5, 4. Now, set your decoder for C9 and solve next week's exciting adventure. See you next week. Out.
Instant Ovaltine, a fortified food drink that tops them all.